stations about volcanoes. This is a sheet where I made at home. First of all, I went on my dad's and my stepmom's iPad, and then I searched up 5 facts, but then I added more because I put too much sentences. So then I shortened them up, and then I put some about Pompeii at the top, and then I did lava map my family, and what the tallest volcano is, but I got most of the facts, and then I added more the other day. Anyone know what the volcano was called in Pompeii? That's it, yeah. Does anyone, this is a fact I've written down, is the one for the Pompeii was buried under millions of volcanic ashes. Does anyone know when Pompeii was discovered? Luke.
Was it around in the 1880s?
No.
Okay, 1960s?
No. May
1740.
Yeah. Does anyone know what the biggest volcano is in Europe? The biggest volcano in Europe. Is in Italy, in Europe. It's called Mount Etna. It is in Italy. And the biggest volcano in the world is Mount Mauna Kea. It is over 33,000 feet tall. What causes volcanic eruptions?
When the ground is open, it causes earthquakes which makes it close and pushes the volcanic lava up to cause magma, then where magma is formed, the lava then shoots straight up out the volcano and spits out, and
yeah. Matt, does anyone know what I'm saying about that? Because I'm on a different one. Did you know that magma rises through the earth crust or end weaknesses? And about 2,000 people were killed in Pompeii. Volcanoes are usually located where tectonic plates meet. The word volcano originally comes from the name Roman gods of fire. And does anyone know how long planes can fly and not fly for when a volcano erupts? Luke?
Is it 24 hours or 48 hours?
Nope. Mission?
A year.
Pen?
A year.
No. Page?
64 hours?
No. Max?
48?
No. The actual answer is they cannot fly for 6.5 weeks. Because when over ash cloud, it takes a while for it to go, so then it takes 6.5 weeks. So it would disappear like every week, but it wouldn't go as much every day, it would only go a little bit. And then they have to make sure it's safe. Like, if you go to the Atlantic Ocean, there's a massive storm. Sometimes they try to find out the speed on a plane, and sometimes it freezes on the side. And if it happens to that, you can't tell the speed. So it might happen to that, and all the ash might go in the plane's engines and stop it from working, and then it could go down, and then it could actually do more damage to the city, because it might not be able to rebuild it. Thank you for watching, and no, I've got another thing to say. How I made this is, first of all, I got flour, and then I, is, can make this shimp, and then we got a cardboard box, and then we flattened it, and then first of all I painted all of it, the round, the bottom green, because at the bottom sometimes it's grass. And then my mum said, why didn't you add some brown bits to make it a bit like mud? So I added dots of brown, and then we painted all this brown to make it look like the colour of a volcano. Like, so it was like a real volcano, it would be like that. Sometimes, and then it would be black because it would be that, and then it would be black sometimes because of all the mountain where it's not colourful, like not colourful, but it don't have much colour. But and then I kind of used a bit too much paint and sprayed it all around. And then my mum told me a stash tissue in the top.
Why?
I don't know. I said, why don't I paint it grey? But she told me to paint it red. So I painted this brown because I went on the internet and like loads of volcanoes look brown. Like that one there, they don't really look brown. They look brown and a bit of black mixed on them. I took that picture because it just looks, see that ash cloud? But my mum told me to put that one, and then I showed her the picture of one like, this, and she went, oh, well, you painted it now. Any more questions?
How long is it taking to build your work?
It took me, you have to wait 24 hours for the paper to dry, and then you can paint it the next day. But if you, it takes like longer in the day, because sometimes if you do it in the afternoon, you have to wait until the next day in the afternoon. Sophie.
How did you form the shape of the volcano?
Because you put a bottle underneath, and then you keep, you put mostly a thickness on the bottom, but you'd have to do all the layers first, so you know, and then it will stick to the bottom. That's the end of my presentation.